school, I was pretty involved. I played soccer, I was in chorus, I was in a lot of clubs. I struggled with fitting in though. I didn't feel that I was smart enough, that people liked me. I struggled with my weight. I would look in the mirror and hate what I saw. I danced throughout high school, and that was one of the things that made me happy. When I was dancing, I felt free, and that is what I wanted to do the rest of my life. And I remember being told that I wasn't skinny enough for that to be my career, and that really crushed me. I felt worthless, and I acted out in a lot of ways behaviorally. I developed an eating disorder because I wanted to be skinny and I wanted to feel like I belonged. The first time I had a drink, I was probably 15. I got drunk that night. I remember that. I was anxious to go to college because I wanted to get away from this area. I was excited about a new start, and I thought that I was going to find myself there. I went to Millersville University, and my roommates were from Philadelphia and were much more experienced than I was. And within the first week of college, I had tried ecstasy, acid. I was snorting cocaine, drinking every night. All I did was party, and I did not do any schoolwork. And I ended up failing out of college.
I heard about your overdose. I won't lose faith in you. I wrote you just to show you hope. I remember when you used to laugh until you cried, but now them tears are different, hurt you plotting suicide. Yeah, I spoke to your mother, she said it's getting worse, and every time she leaves the room you stealing from her purse. Don't you get it? She would die for you to change your course, but you're so selfish that you're gonna say you hate her for it. Damn, is this really who you thought you'd be? Your own family don't trust you on their property. Your sanity is slipping. I really wish you talked to me. The devil stole your soul and now you have to pay the cost, I see. But I'm still praying that you never have to hurt again. I know you feeling like a loser, don't deserve to win, but you can find your way, only have to search within. Sincerely, a concerned friend.
Up moving home with my parents, I was able to maintain some abstinence for about a year, and then I decided to go to Penn College. So I got a job at Ruby Tuesday in Williamsport, and I got an apartment. Working in the restaurant business, there was a lot of partying going on, and I got right back into that lifestyle. It was right before I turned 21, and I started using a lot of cocaine. I tried heroin for the first time. I was doing Adderall, anything I could get my hands on. And I was staying up all night and trying to go to school and working, while school did not become the priority. And I ended up failing out again. I couldn't hold on to any sort of positive relationships in my life because people didn't want to be around me because my main focus was getting messed up and not dealing with reality. As my addiction progressed, I couldn't afford my habit, and I started stealing from my job. I was manipulating my parents into giving me money. I was basically stealing from everyone that I could to maintain this addiction. And then I got pregnant, and I thought that this would be a chance for me to change my life around for a moment, and that turned out to not be the case for me, and I continued to use throughout my pregnancy. I couldn't stop.
Dear Attic, I keep writing you with no response. All I really need to hear is if you're holding on. I know your dad died, you spiraled further down. See, I had faith at first, you got me really worried now. Your family, you're offered help and then you turn it down. What's it gonna take for you to see this isn't working now? I heard you're homeless cause you tried to take your life again. You ate a whole fucking bottle of some Vicodin. Man, I really miss the way it used to be. I'm always scared you'll die, I think about it and I'm losing sleep. I cannot see a funeral, I will not give a eulogy. I can't keep on defending you while they put you through scrutiny. See, this is real, the last letter I be sending, it's only hurting me, and I cannot keep on pretending that I'm really helping you, cause I don't think you'll ever get it. Sold your soul to the devil, traded love for this addiction. But see, I'm still writing, I don't think I let it go. Why do I keep trying to fix you? Only heaven knows. I see too much potential and I do not think it's set in stone. I'ma tell you one last time to get help and you better go. But as I say this, every part of me is filled with fear. My eyes are hazy and I'm waiting for the smoke to clear. Holding on to hope, but damn, I choked when I saw what appeared. I've been writing all these letters, staring in the mirror. Damn.
I, at this point, had gotten into meth and bath salts pretty bad and was in a pretty downward spiral. And the first 2 years of my son's life were absolutely horrific, and I shouldn't have had him, and you know, he should have been taken away from me, because I was in no position to be a mother. And at this point, not using wasn't an option for me. I didn't know how to make it through a day sober. I had stolen my parents' identities and I got caught. My parents caught me and I ran. And this is where things really got bad for me. I was staying in my car and I wanted to die. I couldn't stand who I was. And you know, I would have these moments where I would look at my child and I would feel bad, but I didn't know how to get out of it. And then one day I saw my face on the news. This would have been in October of 2012, and I knew I was in trouble, and I kept running, and I had this moment where I just realized that I couldn't do it anymore. I couldn't live that way anymore, and I drove myself to the Lancaster State Police barracks, and I turned myself in, and that night, I ended up in Northumberland County Jail, and that is where the reality hit of where my addiction took me. That this girl who came from this good family, nothing bad ever happened to her, and that my addiction led me to a jail cell, hurting the people who loved me the most. That's where my using took me.
All the addicts out there still suffering, just know there's a better way. There's thousands of us that have made it from hell. Now we're living the life. And I'm telling you, you gotta find another way. Fight or drown, what will you choose?